One in five Australians suffer from hay fever. The combination of windy weather and high pollen is nothing to sneeze at. Rewind to Melbourne, November 21, 2016.
Oh my God.
A freak weather event triggered a trail of respiratory destruction.
As a storm dumped tons of ryegrass pollen onto Melbourne, thousands of people suffered critical asthma attacks.
One of the worst ever recorded globally, with over 10,000 people presenting to emergency departments. And tragically, in one night, 10 people died of asthma, which is an extraordinary and terrible statistic.
You don't need to be an asthmatic for thunderstorm asthma to kill you. Professor Douglas has spearheaded a study to identify who is at risk and how they can prevent an attack.
Now, studies showed that you could do blood tests and also breathing tests that were actually helpful in finding those who were at greatest risk.
A simple blood test can identify the level of antibodies you have to pollen.
And then they could be perhaps prescribed or recommended preventive treatment to keep them well during the hay fever season and prevent thunderstorm asthma attacks.
Danielle West was diagnosed with asthma as a child.
Struggling to breathe it was very scary when you have the attacks.
Her message to everyone, whether you suffer from asthma, hay fever or neither.
Go to your GP, get tested. I'm now on medications and I've not had an attack for a very long time.
Natasha Rexelby, FTN News First.